Hey folks, I'm Daryl Cagle, and we're doing part two of the error cartoon. I'm going to be piecing together my drawing that I scanned in two pieces, and I'm going to color it in Photoshop. And join me, and it shall all be good. So here we are. This is the left side, the right side. Here's the left side from the other scan. Let's flip that. And we'll widen the canvas. Move it over. Well, it doesn't want to move over, does it? I've been having that problem with Photoshop. It wants to fight me on moving things around. So we'll see if it moves. I used to be able to hold the command key down and then just be able to. Oh, there, it worked. Good. Funny command key. Okay, this one, copy, paste it on here. And we will move this one over. That's not going to let me do it. Same problem as before, huh? It's not accepting the key command. Oh, darn Photoshop. Let's see if this moves it. Move it with the keys. So if you folks have not followed, I do appreciate the follows. That'll give you an email when I come on to stream, which is nice. Ah, so given a little taste of key command might make it a little friendlier to giving me the key to move it over. That looks close enough. Take a chunk of that out. So I'm just cleaning it up a little bit. Oops. That's better. This is just the housekeeping you have to do every time you do a darn cartoon. Come in, clean it up, bump up the contrast so that it looks like I drew it in ink. And we'll get it going. All right, I think that looks good. So let's take it all and I will bump up the contrast. And I need to do this in a few little bits because Photoshop doesn't really respond well to bumping up the contrast. You'd think 100% contrast would mean 100% contrast, but no, it doesn't. So it takes a few tries. Get it bumped up. All right, now let's grab that. There we are. Copy, new, return, paste. There we go. This is the cartoon in position. I think I might rotate it a little bit. Move it up just a skosh. That looks better. Now let's make it 1000 dpi, because it is line art. Oops, I didn't mean to do that. Let's undo that. Image size 1000 dpi. Let's make that 8 inches wide and 5.75 tall. There we go. So if you weren't around for my last video, to see what I drew last time, this is going to be our new error cartoon. And we have an issue on the website where we're killing more cartoons recently because we have new editorial standards. We're not going to do the dirty stuff like we used to. Let the cartoonists do, and so we're killing a bunch more cartoons, and now they leave holes in the site where we need to have a error cartoon. Let's get some little pieces up here to be a little cleaner. That looks like it's got some fill going on. Up and up, and that's better. Okay, now we'll take all of it, we will make it bitmap, flatten layers okay, 50% threshold okay, and there we go. All right. Now I need to start coloring this. Now what I'm going to do is come through this and clean it up, because there's always junk around, and this is the house cleaning that you need to do every time you do a cartoon. Come in and clean up all the little specks. We call them hickeys. And what's interesting about this is that you'd think this is dirty because I'm drawing in pencil, but it doesn't really work that way. Scans require just as much cleanup when I work in pen. The
This may be the most common cartoon you see on Kegel.com, depending on how often we're killing cartoons, which so far looks like quite a bit. Clean up my drawing errors as well as the hickeys. These aren't really errors, these are just draw quick and sloppy. If I was drawing with pen, traditionally, I would be working hard not to make these errors in the first place, and that would keep me working pretty tight when I want to be loose. So all you folks out there who are not chatting, you should follow. You should sign up on Twitch so that... oh, look at that mess that happened from the way I chopped it together. That off. We sometimes get cartoonists submitting cartoons that are really quite dirty, and it just makes you think, why the heck aren't they doing their house cleaning? Look at this junk. Yeah, I could send out a cartoon that has all these hickeys, but I think that's kind of rude. Those are eraser crumbs. I'm not going to need to do a black and white version of this one either, because it's only for use on the website as the placeholder for the errors. But I wanted to do a nice job of it because there are so many errors. You'll be seeing this cartoon a lot. Widen this one up a little bit. Zinlo, nice to see you here. Have you been here before, Zinlo? A little more bumps on the old trunk, I think, look good. Once I get this cleaned up. Oh, you come here quite a bit, huh, Zinlo? I don't remember seeing you. I suspect that you're one of those quiet lurkers. We do have the lurkers. Let's give this a little bit of water breaking through. Okay. Now, have I cleaned it all up to my satisfaction? There's a little bit of something. Yeah, close enough, I think. So let's save that. Now I'm going to make it into a... I'm going to do CMYKA anyway, just because I'm used to doing that. And then I'll change it to RGB at the end. So let's... save as. So, sorry to lose you, Hellward. Error cartoon. This will be 400 dpi. CMYK. We'll give it some extra layers. Oops, nope, I have to make it CMYK first. Just because I usually draw for print, and so might as well follow the same procedure, save it as RGB at the end. Then I'll have a CMYK version. Oops, where'd that happen? I'll have a CMYK version in case I ever need one. Alrighty. I tell you, all of the cartoonists with all the Trump fervor are really pretty nasty now. That's why we have to have a killed cartoon spot. Okay, let's select the color range. All, select color range. Okay, and I will fill that with 100K. select the inverse and delete. Go back to the inverse and let's fill up with that 100K again a couple of times, because at least my version of Photoshop doesn't like to fill with 100K. It resists. So we'll see if it did. Did it accept it? It did. Now I'll go to the bottom and I will make it all white. 0000. Gotta check. Sometimes it wants to do 1111 and then that looks like garbage. And we will fill. And now I'm gonna reduce it to 400K. You think I'd vote for Trump's re-election? We'll see if he does a good job. How'd I do that at 600? Should have been 1,000. Let's do 400. Okay, now that'll give me nice softer edges on those lighter lines that want to have some sophistication rather than just being extra hard. Zinlo writes, it's all about jobs, jobs, jobs. Well, I don't know. Building up the military, sending more people to Iraq, fight ISIS. I'm not sure that's about jobs. Transgender bathrooms, is that about jobs? Cutting money to Planned Parenthood, is that about jobs? Not all about jobs. It's about keeping your base happy. Top layer multiplies, and that lets the colors run behind the cartoons. So I'm just going to start laying in some base colors, things that I know that they should be. And we'll start with that. 25 and 50, that looks like not a bad Statue of Liberty, maybe 33. Yeah, let's do that. And we'll call that Liberty. If I was more meticulous about this stuff, I would do a better job of my layer labeling. My perspective on transgender people is just be nice. I like that the Statue of Liberty is green. That's kind of funny. So I'm just laying in the edges, and then I'll come fill the inside, and then I'll add a little bit of light and dark to give it some lights and shadows and three-dimensionality. So, Zinlo, how much help do you think transgender people should have? Should the military have paid for Chelsea Manning's sex change operation? I'm guessing Trump would say no. I think conservatives are just obsessed with sex. They want to regulate all the sex other people have. They're intensely interested in other people's sexual issues. Big difference between liberals and conservatives. Okay, let's give Uncle Sam a base of 4. How's that look? That looks like Uncle Sam. 4, 20, 25. On this Whack-a-M Cintiq, I don't have that nice wheel in the upper right that I can use to change my brush size. I can probably program that some different way so that it's easier, but I haven't quite figured that out. So if this were for print, you would see the black lines running over the color, and that would keep you from getting those little halos. Since this is not for print, none of that matters too much. DWC309, how many days have I been alive? You don't want to just ask me how old I am. You want me to multiply. Usually what I get is, you must be the oldest guy on Twitch. I did have a white beard for a while. Zinlo writes, I'm probably more libertarian on the trans issue. I don't care either way. We have much bigger problems in this country. So just let them use whatever bathroom. Good. You sound like an enlightened conservative libertarian. Libertarians are not, by and large, obsessed with other people's sex lives and wanting to regulate the bedroom. One thing I like about libertarians. All right, let's give the elephant a base color. Let's make him 15, 15, 5. How's that look? A little bit of a dirty purple. If I was doing this for newspapers, I wouldn't have put that little bit of yellow in there to make the dirty purple, because everything loses its color intensity when it's in print. Hey, Leonardo, nice to see you here. monkey. Let's give him a little bit of hair. Hair of the same color. So do you think Donald Trump's hair is the same color as his flesh? That's a question I sometimes grapple with. I'll do the water separately on a higher layer so I don't have to worry about those edges. Looks like the stream is working okay today. Not much in the way of tech issues going on now. Twitch is doing the job. You know, I get a whole lot of mail from readers urging me to make Trump more orange. And I noticed some other cartoonists are going pretty heavy in the orange. There's a number of them that give him a kind of a farmer's tan, which is, you know, the orange stops at his collar if he's not wearing a shirt, or it's just on his hands and not on the rest of his arms. And I don't think that's right. I think he goes into the spray tan and wears the goggles, which is why he's got the white around his eyes. So why do you love Trump, Zinlo? Is he finally giving you the revenge on government that you've been waiting for? You eager to see all the cuts? Leonardo surprised that Trump hasn't issued an executive order barring people from commenting on his tan. Yes, DWC the Orange is about his tan. Let's give this a little bit of flag blue. And a little bit of flag red. I thought about putting Trump into this error cartoon. And I decided better to just keep these iconic editorial cartoon characters. Large Marge, nice to see you. I don't know that I've seen you here before, Large Marge. You need to follow. You know, Zinlo, people accuse me of being mainstream media. I get letters from people saying that I'm using the talking points that I got from the Democrats and how terrible I am to take my marching orders from them. But this is not the case. Editorial cartoonists are largely ignored in that equation. If they sent me talking points, it would be interesting. I would talk about it. And I wouldn't necessarily say what they want me to say, but I'd talk about the talking points, to be clear. But they don't. Because they're all word people. Oh, thank you, Large Marge. And thank you, Zinlo, for the kind words. I do get accused of that, though. On my Wacom, at my other location, I've got a broken button. And it does... Oh, well, thank you for the follow. I appreciate that. I didn't look quick enough to see who was following, but I appreciate it. Okay. Use a little bit of this up here. Just blocking in the colors. Oh, Large Marge, you just followed. Thank you so much. You just showed up on the follow tally. Right, let's go with an extra light blue in the water, and I'll add a little detail to that. Let's call it 22. It's me bumping that button on the pen that I don't have on the other pen. Stylus, I should say. Terrible place to put the button right where you need to draw with the pen. Maybe I should break this pen too. I complained about this button to Wacom, and what they said was, "Oh, we're so sorry, we'd be happy to send you a new stylus." Which was really a very nice corporate thing to say. I'm not sure I need a new stylus, though. Which of these characters are my favorite? You know the story with Liberty, right? So Liberty, on 9/11, just about every cartoonist in the world drew a weeping statue of Liberty in front of the burning Twin Towers, and it was a real time of embarrassment for editorial cartoonists. It was all drawing the same thing at the same time. You know, we're accused of all being too derivative of each other. What background do I want here? I might go with something like an orange. Can do whatever I want with a stupid cartoon here. Let's try that orange. See if I like it. And so, you know, in The Onion, they do these mock editorial cartoons, and every one of them has a weeping Statue of Liberty in it, and that's because it's the poor cartoonists at our low point. That's all right. In case you wondered why there's a weeping Statue of Liberty in all those editorial cartoons in The Onion, it's because they're rubbing salt in our editorial cartoonist collective wound. This is the background. Now, what to do next? Let's give it some texture. Lighten it up a little bit. This is actually a genuine sponge that I scanned and made into a stamp tool. Large Marge writes, because it was overused. Well, a little more than that, Marge. It's because editorial cartoonists also are often duplicative of one another, and it's a sore spot for us, particularly with editors. You guys all draw the same thing at the same time. Well, you know, we're all middle-aged white guys drawing off of the same palette of cliches drawn from the same popular cultural history background on the same topics every day, whatever they're talking about on CNN and Fox News and MSNBC. And so naturally, we're going to come up with, well, let's undo that. We're going to come up with similar solutions to the same problem. We're also dealing with editors who want the same solutions from us and reprint the same kind of solutions all the time. And it's a bit unfair because columnists don't suffer from that same mindset, and columnists are just as duplicative of each other in their stupid matching opinions that they just derive from each other and regurgitate with a few changes of word. And yet, since they're words and you don't glance at them and see the similarity, they don't get the grief that cartoonists do. Bottom line, life is unfair. Pound at 00. You're a new fella here. Nice to see you. You need to follow. I need all the follows I can get. Because I'm so bad about announcing when I'm going to stream that that's the way you find me. Yes, Leonardo, I have a bit of angst about columnists. It annoys me that the columnists are pundits on TV talking about every topic, and you know, editorial cartoonists have a larger audience. Nobody tears a column out and sticks it on their fridge. Our images overpower the words on the page. Yet, whenever a cartoonist goes on TV, it's always for a conversation about, where'd you learn to draw like that? What's your favorite cartoon? What's your funniest cartoon? Rather than talking about any of the issues, where a cartoonist could be quite articulate. No, that goes to people who say the same thing in words as each other. Darn button. Editorial cartoonists are just columnists, except that we do it in images. Pound it asks if I know John Arbuckle. John Arbuckle, like the guy who owns Garfield in the comic strip? All right. Let's give it a little bit of... I think they're kind of behind a wall, kind of like the Muppets. So let's give it a little bit of wall texture. Just a little bit of wall texture, because they're on a wall. Like Bert and Ernie, Elmo. I worked for the Muppets for about 20 years. I still have Muppets dancing in my brain. John Arbuckle, the cartoon character, is himself a cartoonist. I didn't know that. I guess I haven't been reading my Garfield carefully enough. I have met Jim Davis, who draws Garfield. Oops, that was an error. Which one is Warren Beatty? It's on your mind tonight, huh? All right, let's give this a little bit of... background orange, that would be nice. Oops. No, that's right. That was 100%. That's why it was bad. I'll do that. Pound it. What did I do for the Muppets? I designed about 2,000 Muppet products in the 1980s. I put Muppets on kids' shoes and Timex watches and glasses at McDonald's. I drew Sesame Street and Pigs and Frogs. I worked on designing the original Muppet Babies characters. I worked on Fraggle Rock. All right, what do I want to do with those Timex? Yes, I did a line of Muppet watches for Timex. Did I mention that? Okay, let's go with light yellow 100%. If you go to darylcagle.com and click on my portfolio link, I think I have some of my Muppet samples there, along with other advertising illustration samples. Most of my career I was a character illustrator, advertising illustrator. Um, Yeah, I should do the water drops at the right, but I'm laying in things broadly here. I need to come in and add detail, light, and color. And that'll be some detail to the water too, so I'll get to that. But thank you for reminding me. So pound it. You think I'm not old enough to retire? Good. That's about the only compliment I get as the oldest guy on Twitch. No, I have a different career now. I run a small business that distributes my cartoons and the cartoons from about 100 other cartoonists to about 850 newspapers that subscribe to our cartoons. And I love being an editorial cartoonist much more than being an illustrator, because as an illustrator, I was always solving other people's art problems. And as an editorial cartoonist, I'm imposing my opinions on others. And that's so much fun. Very gratifying. Be part of the public debate is gratifying. Makes you feel like you have a place in the world. Live as long as you. How old are you, DWC? Leonardo, you know one person on Twitch that's older than me? Somehow that makes me feel good. Only one. Okay, those are 50% yellow. I think I'm going to bump this up to 90% yellow. What the hell? 100% yellow. Why hold back? I'm going to do the alternate balloons in yellow. Hey, it's an error cartoon. It should have some bold color, huh? Says the room is in R9K mode. I don't know R9K mode. Hey, if I could be the Bob Ross of editorial cartoons, that would be great. The Bob Ross of editorial cartoons. Oops, I went out of the line. Bob Ross never goes out of the line. I don't know about R9K mode. I do have this bot set up to not take obscene comments, but I didn't see it kick in. There haven't been any obscene comments. So it should accept your... If it rejected your comment, I would get a little notice here that asks me if I want to approve it, and that did not happen. Okay. Now these characters need some more definition. So let's start with Uncle Sam here. Now grab his flesh tone. Large Marge, nice to see you here. Oh, yes, Leonardo, I have the automatic moderator set up, And I like the automatic moderator. But it has not censored any of you. You've all been polite. Okay, let's call this one the tones layer. So Zinlo asks, you're trying to ask what my views are on the Second Amendment. Well, I just lived in Tennessee for 2-3 years, and I get the gun culture. And I went to the NRA convention when it was in Nashville. I was asked to go by this little film company that was doing a documentary on guns, and their shtick for their documentary was that they were going around the country to different gunny kind of places. They went to Hartford, Connecticut, for example, where the Colt factory is, and interviewed our cartoonist in Hartford, Bob Engelhart. So they came to me because I was a cartoonist in Nashville, and then the NRA convention was in Nashville. And I drew a cartoon bashing the NRA, and I did a walk through the convention with a film crew behind me. And I tell you, that is the easiest way to get NRA people to not like you. Boy, I got some dirty looks. Liberal cartoonists walking through the NRA floor. Well, it looked to me like a pretty freewheeling gun sale environment, Zinlo. I was impressed, too, by how broadly the NRA sees their role in the world beyond guns. They were about every crazy Tea Party issue you can imagine. They do lots of stopping and praying. You would think that they would be an advocacy group for guns, and I think that's just a hook to be into everything. They are into everything. I can give Uncle Sam a little bit of pink in the cheeks. Let's get rid of the C and add some pink. Drop back the opacity, bump up the size a little bit, and we'll get pink ears and pink cheeks. NRA's a gun lobby. They sell guns, and they also sell pro-life and every other conservative issue you can think of. Okay, that's probably all I need on Uncle Sam. I need to clean up the whites of his eyes again. Oops. You need to go to the convention, pound it. Stand up with everybody every time they pray. Did I chase you off, pound it? Is it too painful to listen to someone who doesn't agree with you? One thing that's impressed me about the NRA convention is that it's cheap. I think it costs $25. And when you go into the convention, you do it by buying your NRA $25 license for the whole year. I see why they have so many members. They put on an interesting show. And they're cheap and easy. Not like trying to go to Comic-Con. Boy, compare the NRA to Comic-Con. Comic-Con is so much tougher than the NRA. Boy, this pen, this stylus. Well, my wife was in ROTC in high school. She's got her old target rifle in the garage. So I guess I'm a gun owner too, by joint property. How about the smell? I was told Comic-Con smells like old Doritos, right, Leonardo? I'm a Comic-Con fan. And I think as years have gone by and the thing has turned into more of a general entertainment convention than just being about comics, that the crowd has gotten to be much more general. You don't see Klingons like you used to. People still dress up, though. Maybe it's just a shortage of Klingons. Well, she's got some color there. Oh, I was putting that on the top layer. I make these mistakes. I talk and I don't think. That should have gone on my tones layer. Give her white teeth. What the heck? Even though she's made of copper. Well, let's do the elephant on the tones layer. Tried to buy a Klingon the other day. They were out. Patak. Okay, let's drop this down to here. See, if you do these tones in the same color family using the color picker, it looks like it belongs there. Ooh, that was dark. Let's undo that, lighten it up. I've been working on this 1 hour and 8 minutes. What did I estimate, 1.5 hours? Maybe I'll get it done in 1.5 hours. So, Lyrid Rain, nice to see you here. I haven't seen you here before. You need to follow Lyrid. They are in Kilroy poses. But actually, I was thinking more of the traditional Muppet wall poking out from the Muppet wall. Oh, the reason for this cartoon, you're coming in late, Large Marge, is that I run this website called Kegel.com where we post cartoons by all the top cartoonists, and I run a little newspaper syndicate. And we've been killing more cartoons lately because we're getting more blowback from conservative editors now with Trump. And it's hard to come up with any pro-Trump cartoons, but we're trying to be responsive. And the other complaint that they have is the cartoons being too dirty. And that has also hurt us with editorial cartoons in schools. You know, editorial cartoons are on state-mandated AP social studies testing in 8th and 11th grade. And that's... those are some of our best customers, the textbooks and the actual tests themselves, the testing services that buy the cartoons for the tests. So the fact that the cartoons were too raunchy to be used in the classroom hurt us in the classroom, and it really is something that we should address. So we're being better about better, depending on your point of view. We're being more assertive about killing the dirty cartoons. And when we do, we often end up with a hole on the site with an error where the killed cartoon would have been in someone's archive. And we don't have a good solution for displaying that error. So I'm drawing a cartoon that will be displayed as an error. And it's probably going to be the cartoon people see more than any other cartoon on the friggin' site. Look at me, I'm drawing up at the top again. Jeez. Alright, let's add another layer since I did that on the top. And I'll need a little bit of white. So yeah, I think you're gonna see this cartoon more than any other in all those spots where cartoons got killed on Kegel.com. Oops. And that's why they're saying what they're saying. They're explaining that it's either a technical problem. It can happen if a cartoon is uploaded in an odd format and our programming doesn't quite deal with it correctly, so it would put up an image error. This should show up instead of the image error, which should be nice. All right, I'm going to add some texture to the top here. I should do as you guys suggested as well, and color that water in. And the water needs a little bit of art. Oh, you like my Guernica cartoon? Thank you. That was actually an easy cartoon to do because Picasso had already done the composition for me. All right, I think that looks about right. Now let's add a little bit
Yes, it's like the off-the-air image on TV stations. That's right, Large Marge, except that it's going to be showing up in the page where we would have had a error. My programmer actually picked an old logo from the site that he blows up much too big, and it looks terrible. It looks like the error has an error, so this is needed. And apparently, well, I'm told it's difficult for us to, when we kill cartoons, to make them, make their spots disappear on Kegel.com. So we end up with these error spots for cartoons that we deleted in the syndicate, but they automatically sent themselves over to Kegel.com to update. I should have taken composition from you in college, Leonardo. Have you noticed how much texture Trump has on his face? My goodness, his face is just full of texture. I like putting texture on stuff like this because it, to my eye, it looks like I'm drawing on a textured paper or painting on a textured paper. And I think that's kind of charming. I noticed that on the, now that we have these big HD TVs, you really see people's complexions, and Trump's got lots of pores going on. He's got some serious complexion. That's better. I can do a light little bit on the donkey. Now the donkey needs some brown. Forget how old Trump is. I'm not sure how related the textural complexion is to age. Yeah, you get wrinkles as you get older, but I'm not sure that you gather that texture. I'm 60, so multiply that by 365 for how many days old I am. And I don't have that kind of texture. Trump's 10 years older than me, but I don't expect to have that texture in 10 years. Well, let's see if we like this. I'll put this on its own layer, so in case I don't like it, I can get rid of it more easily. Let's call this a multiply layer.
And boom, 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 boom. That's kind of nice. Large Marge, I do not use lettering fonts. I hand letter everything. And I encourage all the young aspiring cartoonists to also hand letter and don't use the fonts. Well, thank you, Large.
Rasterdax. Right, Rasterdax writes, I wouldn't know how to respond to someone who tells me I have an interesting texture. I'd consider washing my face, probably. Rasterdax. Rasterdax, you need to follow. I'm not getting the follows that I need.
That'll tell you when I'm back on, and then you can not lose me next time by not knowing I'm here. Okay, let's get just a little bit of lightness in their fingernails. I like for fingernails to be a little bit lighter. It's the top layer, should be giving me more light. Why is it not? 50%? Not quite sure. Why is it not? Is that another layer? Oh, it's not, because it's on the multiply. And the multiply was making it not look like anything. Sometimes I gotta figure out what I did wrong. I put it on multiply because I wanted to have that black texture not displace any of the color underneath it. Oops. Come on. That's my broken button. I could be at a point where I quit. No, I haven't done the water details like I said I would. Let's bump that up. We'll give it a little bit of blue water details. That needs to go lighter. Been working on this an hour and 23 minutes. What did I do? I predicted an hour and a half, right? Yeah, it's pretty close. Close enough. I think my error cartoon is done. What do you think? Finished. All right. So you're going to see this. Every time you see this on Kegel.com, you're going to wonder, what's the terrible, nasty, obscene thing the cartoonist drew to make this cartoon show up in his spot? And that's what you got to be asking. because there's going to be some reason why you see this, and it's usually not going to be a technical problem. It's usually going to be an editorial problem. Donkey Nose needs a logo. Okay, folks. Thank you for all the kind words. You're very nice, and it was nice having more comments this time. So please follow and keep your eyes out for me, and I will be back drawing the new cartoon before too long. Thank you for all the kind words. Thank you, Large Marge. Thank you, Rastardax Hellward, Leonardo. You guys are all great. Okay, so we'll mark the end of this video. I will post it on darylcagle.com along with my other videos. There are a great collection of past cartoons and videos of me drawing the past cartoons live on Twitch. So please go take a look at darylcagle.com and go to kagle.com to see all the best cartoons by all the best cartoonists in the world, along with this error cartoon that I just drew. You'll see that show up here and there. And go to kagle.com/heroes if you'd like to support kagle.com. We really do appreciate your support. And thank you much, folks, and I will see you again. Thank you, Lyrid Rain. End of video.